Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Italian sausage subs. And we start with Italian sausage, and I decided to go ahead and cook this and then explain what I've used here. I used Italian sausage that was packaged like this. And this is the mild Italian. You can also get the hot if you like that. This is 1 pound and 2 ounces, or altogether 18 ounces in one package. I decided to use two packages like this, and I split them in thirds. Now there is a skin on each one, so you have to peel that off before you start processing it. But my thirds ended up looking like this after they were browned. I didn't add any oil, I didn't add any water, I just put the pieces of sausage in the skillet and I tended to them so that I could continually turn them and let them brown up on all sides, and in the meantime they were cooking through to the center. So now I'm going to lift the sausage out and set it in a bowl here. We'll come back to put those on our sandwiches. So if you have something that is like a strainer, it will help you to keep the oil back in the skillet. And a lot of people would immediately use that oil to continue with the rest of the recipe, where we're going to be softening some vegetables, but I don't like for it to be that greasy. So I have a little cup here that I'm going to pour the excess grease off. But I want to keep all that wonderful flavor that is in the fond that is left in the bottom of the skillet. So I'm draining all of it out, but leaving all of this. So now what we can do is deglaze the skillet with some water, 1/4 cup of water, and then just stir until it makes a little gravy for you to saute your vegetables in. And that doesn't have it all loosened, but you get the idea. The vegetables I have: one green pepper, bell pepper, chopped. Mine was a little on the small side, but I would suggest a large green bell pepper, chopped. And then one onion chopped. Again, mine was on the small side, but I needed to use it. Probably you'll want one large onion chopped, unless you want to go light on the vegetables. And then I have one clove of garlic that is chopped very finely. So once you get those in to your deglazed pan, take that back to the stove and just cook until they're softened. Now we're going to continue to make our sauce. I want to show you what I have after sauteing the vegetables. I did add another 1/4 cup of water because this dried out pretty soon, and you don't want it sticking, even though I was able to get all of the good fond from the bottom and sides, and it helps when it sticks for you to kind of get those off. But you should have about this much liquid in the bottom when you finish, and if you have to add extra water, that's fine. Now we're going to add jarred spaghetti sauce or Italian sauce. This happens to be Newman's Own. I usually use Prego. It's just up to you. Everybody has their favorite. It doesn't have to be any particular flavor. This is tomato and basil, which is fine. But yours might be traditional or meat flavored or whatever. 24-ounce jar. Put that in with the sauce. And that has most of it. Now we're adding 1 teaspoon of dry basil, 1 teaspoon of dry oregano, and stirring that together. And that's our complete sauce. So we have our sausages cooked and browned. We have our sauce. And right here I have sliced mozzarella cheese. This is very thinly sliced. So if you have to ask at your deli for them to slice it, especially for you, you can get it this thin. But I'll be using some submarine buns or something similar. You can use brat buns if you like. I'm going to put 2 over here in my 13x9x2 baking dish because when I separate these into individual sub buns, I'm going to need to open that with a knife, and when I open it, it will lay out and take up half the pan, and then likewise on this one. So I'm going to take a slight break and get a knife and open those and come back and continue with putting together our Italian sub. You can see that I've opened one of the buns and just take a knife, and I like to put it on end, and then I can see halfway across and then grab it at the top and just keep it equally spaced all the way down, and you have the other one open. So now what we're going to do is place some sausages on there, and I'm trying to keep everything equalized so that we use exactly what is here and don't need more and don't have a lot left over. There are 30 of the pieces of sausage, and the buns in this bag, there were 6 whole buns. So that means with what I have here, I'm using 1/3 of the buns, using 2 whole buns. So I need to use 1/3 of the 30, which would be 10, so 5 on each. So you can adjust that if you want to. It doesn't have to be exactly what I'm doing. I'll put another one there. I think 5 is very generous for each person, but since I only have the 6 buns to work with, I have a lot of materials to put on them. And you could serve these open-faced and just consider a half is a serving. After you have the sausage on, then you're going to put some of your sauce and try to keep it in proportion so you'll have enough to do all that you want. So we're just spreading sauce. And it doesn't have to be neat because we're going to put this in the oven, and cheese will be on it. The cheese will start melting, and things will run together. So don't worry too much about perfection. So after you get a certain amount of sauce on, whatever you've decided, then you can put your cheese slices on. Again, try to look ahead and see how much more cheese you need, and don't use it up on the first go around. But you want to give adequate cheese to these. So I'm going to just I've done 3 down the center, and we'll do a couple more. I think I'll scoot that up and do another 3. I really like cheese. And you'll want to cover that over with a small layer of sauce. And spread that out. And for now, I'm just doing these two for demonstration purposes, but I will eventually do the rest in the same manner. And these are ready to go to a 400 degree oven, and it only takes 5 to 10 minutes. Our Italian sausage subs are out of the oven and they're hot right now, and that's when you want to serve them. And they did take probably 10 to 12 minutes. It just depends on how brown and bubbly you want them. These could have stayed longer or they could have come out a little earlier. But I'm going to take a spatula that's long. If you have something like this, it's just convenient to go all the way under. And it's kind of sticking at one end. So I'll just peel that up and bring it onto a serving plate. And that mozzarella cheese is stringing like that, like you expect. Oops. So that's the look of the dish we were making today, the Italian sausage subs. Here's my favorite drink, regardless of what I'm testing. This is iced tea, and I decided to do the open face version for me because I didn't want all of it. And also it's a little easier for me to just use my fork and knife, cut down through this and make sure I get some of everything, which means some bread, some cheese, some sauce, some sausage. And we'll try this. Very big bite. Everything tastes great. That bread was a little hard for me to cut through, and I took a big piece of it in my mouth. But the fact is, it's just very crunchy and crispy. It was that done, but not burned or anything. It's just a very nice texture to have for this sub. And I love the sauce, tasted great. Love the mozzarella cheese, and the sausage was great. So I don't think you can beat this in terms of a quick to fix sandwich type deal that is a little more than just a sandwich, almost into the casserole venue, but not quite. I hope you enjoy it.